My name is Brandy, aka PixelatedTwix, and if you're new here, welcome to my little corner. If you're an OG, welcome back. Happy Wednesday, guys. As you can tell, we're doing a cast video today. I created two special ladies for Keo Sims here on YouTube. She's hosting a bachelor challenge, and if you guys haven't met her, I suggest you stop by and tell her I sent you. All right, well, let's get into this video. I don't want to waste your time today. All right, before I officially introduce you to our ladies, I would like to give you a little background on them and their family. The Ricci twins were born in Tuscany, Italy, to a Black American female officer and an Italian father whose family owned a fairly successful vineyard and winery. And although it wasn't quite a humble existence, the Ricci family wasn't, you know, rich, but they live comfortably, and they wanted to make sure that their daughters receive the best. You know, they made sure they went to private schools, were classically trained in violin, and they wanted them to be a little worldly, so they made sure that they learned multiple languages, of course Italian, Spanish, and English, or in this case, Simlish. So the girls were very well educated, and you know, that was important to the family. Their expectations are that the girls will take over the vineyard when their grandparents and parents were ready to retire. All right, so let me introduce you to Liberty Ricci. She is the oldest of the twins by 10 minutes, and so because she's the oldest, she has fondly taken over responsibility of looking after her younger sister, Ari. So this kind of goes along with Liberty's leader of the pack aspiration, because she's always taken on leadership roles. She has a full-time job and in an office, but outside of that, she does help with procuring contracts for her family's business, as well as dealing with directly with any of their customers. But this isn't something that she wants to do full-time. Liberty wants to own her own business or become the CEO of a large corporation, and because of these aspirations, it kind of butts head with her family from time to time, because that is not what they were expecting of their daughters. They have an obligation to take over the family business because that's who they want to pass it on to. Now Liberty has other struggles outside of her family. Her day-to-day struggles in her own career have, you know, been a bit of a stressor for her, because she is one of the few females at her office, so it's a male-dominated environment, and she isn't always treated fairly. And then on top of that, her dating pool is usually within her peer circle, and men are also intimidated by her. She is extremely intelligent, and she finds herself dumbing herself down quite a bit because she wants to date, and no man will approach her at the office. And so this is completely against her character, because Liberty is extremely ambitious. She's highly motivated. She's aggressive, and she's a self-starter. And so this corporate world suits her very well, but she realizes that she has to play the game to make it. I did give her the leader of the pack aspiration because she is the type of sim that works well in groups. She bounces off other people's energy, she vibes off of people, and she loves to be the center of attention. She commands a room when she enters it, and because of this, She tends to have very little female companionship. As a matter of fact, the only female friend she has is her sister Ari, and you know, they don't always get along because they are opposites, even though they're twins. So that's just another damper on her life. And you know, she is a gorgeous Sim, but you know, men tend to friend zone her and women tend to flee. But that is a day in the life of Liberty. I kind of feel sorry for her, you know, but she's got a good head on her shoulders and she's a strong-willed Sim, so you know, she will get through this just like she gets through everything else, especially if she has the support of her sister and her family. But you know, she realizes that this may not always be, especially if she just decides to pack up and move to San Myshuno with or without Ari. And she may just do that, especially since she found out about this rich bachelor over in the city who is looking for a new wife. So she sees this as an amazing opportunity for her to hit the road, Jack, and never come back to Tuscany. But again, she doesn't want to leave her sister behind, and she realizes that her sister may or may not leave, so she's got to think of a way to trick her sister into leaving with her. And speaking of which, I'd like you to meet Ari Ricci. She is the second born of the twins. Of course, she's the youngest. And she is also classically trained in violin. And however, she prefers playing her guitar. You can find Ari always hidden somewhere alone in the vineyards, playing around on her guitar or running through the fields because that's how she gets her exercise. She does like to be alone a lot of the time, but don't think that she is a loner. She definitely loves to socialize. She is quieter, but she can do well in social settings, and especially if she's comfortable with the people that are around her. But it takes her a long time to get warmed up to people, which I can completely relate to because I'm the same way. I can be a little shy at first, but once I feel comfortable around people, you can't get me to shut up. And that's kind of how Ari is. She's definitely happy-go-lucky. She loves life, enjoys it to its fullest, and she especially loves her Italian city, Tuscany, and she adores her family's vineyard. And so she is looking forward to taking over the vineyard and the winery one day, and she tries to make it her priority to learn everything she possibly can about how to run the family business. And she even dabbles in making wine herself, which is why she has the aspiration for mixologist. She's made some wine that has actually done very well for the family, so she's got a bit of a talent there. She is her father's daughter for sure, but she is kind of disappointed that her sister Liberty doesn't want to run the family business with her, but she understands that her sister has her own goals, own aspirations, and she won't hold her back. But she definitely doesn't want her to leave Italy, and yet she understands that this is something that her sister must do. So she's resorted to the idea that she will be running this business alone. Ari wants to have a family, but that is not her main priority. Her family is first with the vineyard, and you know, one day maybe she'll meet someone, maybe not. She's not too much in a rush into getting married or having a family. She's got a lot on her plate with the vineyard and winery, and she's just enjoying her life. It's very relaxed and quiet, and she likes it that way. She is a country girl. She spends a lot of her time running around in the vineyard. Most of the time she's dirty, grungy, but she does like to dress up every now and then and go out to the pubs and, you know, to the festivals. She loves her people. She loves Italy, like I've said before. She's a foodie. She definitely is in the kitchen a lot. Her favorite thing to make is homemade pasta and homemade sauces. So she is kind of wife material in that way, because she does love to cook and she believes in having a happy home. And she is a family sim, or family oriented sim, but she looks out for herself, even though her sister believes that she can't take care of herself. But Ari's a little more resilient than Liberty gives her credit for. And with the news of a possible new customer over in San Myshuno, Ari finds herself traveling overseas with Liberty to meet this so-called new buyer. And she will find out just how resilient she really can be, having to deal with the truth behind why they're actually there. And, you know, now having to stay behind to, I guess, become the protector of her older sister now. So I'm going to leave it there with you guys, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. I love the feedback. And if you've made it this far, don't be shy. Smash that subscribe button so you can become a part of our family, and ring the bell so you don't miss an upload, because I upload every week. And don't forget to stop by Keo Sim's channel here on YouTube, where you will see the twin story continue with her bachelor challenge. Until next time, guys, ciao.